Moist and eggless pineapple drenched cake is layered with whipped cream frosting, creating a perfect balance of tang and creamy sweetness. Finally decorated with beautiful pineapple flower, which was dried, and sugar balls. Hi everyone, this is your host Sharmila and welcome back to my channel Sharmila's Kitchen. Today I'll be making eggless pineapple cake with whipped cream frosting. Making dried pineapple flour is so simple and easy. Cut the pineapple in thin roundels and line them up in a muffin tin. Once they dehydrate, the sides of the pineapple roundels go up and look like a flower. Now pop them up in the oven for 180 degrees centigrade for 30 minutes. If the slices are not shrunken and dried out completely, continue dehydrating for more 10 minutes. Now let's make the whipped cream frosting. In a bowl, take chilled whipped cream. Sugar has already added in the cream. So just beat on medium to high speed for 2 minutes until thick, fluffy and forms soft peaks. If you turn the bowl of whipped cream upside down, the cream won't fall off at all. So this is the right consistency, thick, light, creamy and fluffy. Once done, keep in the refrigerator until the cake is baked. Today we are going to be baking the cake in the microwave. So line in a baking mold with a baking paper. If you don't have baking paper, don't worry, then simply grease the mold with oil or butter and dust with flour. To make the pineapple cake, in a bowl add condensed milk, then add oil gradually and mix them until well combined and become thick. Put in curd. We are gonna be making eggless cake, so curd will make the cake soft and spongy. As it is a pineapple cake, so I'm gonna be adding pineapple essence to add the pineapple flavor. Wait, are you whispering? Okay, if you don't have pineapple essence, what to do? You can add vanilla essence too. Just give it a mix with an electric beater. Now in a sieve, add in dry ingredients like flour, baking powder and baking soda. All the ingredients quantities will be listed in the description below. Sieve the dry ingredients in two batches. So after one batch, fold in carefully. If you mix vigorously, the air that trapped in the batter will go away. So be gentle, then sieve the rest of the flour mixture and milk gradually. Fold in until there are no white streaks in the batter. Pour the smooth cake batter in the mold. Pop in the microwave and microwave for 5 minutes. You might remember my 5 minute chocolate cake recipe in microwave. Yes, I am using the same method. Only the ingredients are a little bit different. Once it is ready in 5 minutes, wait for some time to let it cool down. Then take out and remove the parchment paper. As you can see, the cake is super soft and moist. The best part is that it does not have any brown crust. So we don't need to scrape off the sides and top that the other cake recipes require. And no wastage of cake also. We are one step ahead. One more thing, once the cake is baked on the specified time, you should check the cake by inserting any knife or toothpick. If the knife is clean, that means the cake is ready to take out. So this way I made two cakes and let it cool down completely before frosting. Cut the pineapple into small bits and keep aside. Now it's ready to assemble. As I'll be making 4 layered cake, so cut 2 cakes into halves And as you can see, the cake is so soft and airy, light and fluffy. I don't have a cake board, so I'm gonna be using my chopping board, and I secured it with parchment paper so that it remains clean after frosting the cake. Here's one little trick: taking a little bit of frosting, put in the center so that the cake does not move around as you frost. Place a layer of a cake on the cake, sprinkle sugary pineapple juice. It will keep the cake moist. Then create the even layer of whipping cream. On that, add pineapple tidbits. Repeat the same process one after another until 4 layers are done. Then I'm going to crumb coat the cake. All you need to do is cover the whole cake with frosting. After a single coat, keep in the refrigerator to firm for 30 minutes. While it's resting in the refrigerator, here I'm adding yellow color in some of the whipped cream. We'll be using it for second coat. After 30 minutes, add another layer of the cream. The best way to do is go from top to sides. Once the cream is evenly distributed, add yellow cream on the sides, you know, to give a beautiful symmetrical color like pineapple. Then smooth out the top and side. Again, we are not using the yellow color on the top, so top will be purely white. Now using a smoother, smooth out the top. Now I'm using my daughter's scale. Sorry about that, I don't have a professional smoother. Using a cake comb, create some pattern. Now put dried pineapple flowers. You can go creative and decorate as per your choice. Put leftover cream in a piping bag and put some designs on the cake. So I'm generally going back and forth until the design is completed. The cake is almost done. If it is a celebration cake, write some messages, as it was my birthday cake, so I'm writing a message for me. Sprinkle some sugar balls on the top. It's time to cut the cake and celebrate the moment. Let me know, do you like my birthday cake? If yes, write in the comment section. If no, also comment why didn't you like it. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. Share with your family and friends so that they can also make and enjoy their moment. And don't forget to subscribe to my channel. See you, bye bye.